Okay, so I've reviewed a ton of webcams, and this is probably one of my most surprising ones. So I've connected, in this case, the iPhone's integrated camera, an iPhone 12 Pro, with the Epicam software over Wi-Fi. And this is the free version of Epicam from Elgato or Corsair. And just to show you the quality of the camera sensor that's in the iPhone 12 Pro, you can see just how excellent the image is. It's competing with, you know, mirrorless cameras, I would say. It's about as good as the image that was coming out of the DJI Pocket 2 camera, which has probably a double or triple the size of the sensor. Just again, to kind of prove how nice the image is when you capture that out of a phone. Now, one thing that I've done is kind of edit out the watermark. There is a watermark here. You just point to it. There we go, there's a watermark here on the screen when you use the free version of Epicam. But, you know, you can tell that Elgato has really done their homework in terms of being able to do a low latency connection between the phone's Wi-Fi network and the Wi-Fi that's on my laptop. And I synced up the audio a little bit in post. There was a little bit of lag between my microphone here, which is a little bit off frame, the Shure MV7, along with the iPhone. Now, a couple things that you have to be aware of when you set it up. So for Windows, there is a driver that you need to download. That driver then allows basically the camera to be seen on the Wi-Fi network and allows the handshake between the Epicam iOS app and Windows. Now, one thing that tripped me up a little bit was that after I installed the driver, in this case, it's usually a good idea to reboot. In this case, I figured out I had to reboot. So once I rebooted Windows, reconnected, I was able to get my camera from my iPhone connected to my Windows PC with no issues at all. There's another way, using iTunes, to connect it over the USB-C cable from Lightning into USB or USB-A if you have USB-A. That will be another way of doing it. I'm not going to test that here because I just want to test the easiest way to get this configured. So one thing that's nice is if you have maybe an older iPhone around or something that you're not using that's in your drawer, this is probably going to be one of the best webcams that you'll be able to get, and you'll get really good results, I think. You can see the color balance is pretty spot on. You know, all of the blue in the background is correct. The white balance in the background is correct. Skin tones look really good. Light's coming through pretty well. You know, everything is looking, you know, pretty sharp in terms of image. There's not any real noise that I can see in the background. It just shows up like any other webcam. I've added a microphone because I wasn't able to hear audio from the iPhone over Wi-Fi feed. I think it adds it if you buy the Pro version of the Epicam app for about $8. But, you know, if you're in a pinch and you want a good quality webcam, probably the best quality webcam of most of the devices in your house, and you want to record something that's a bit nicer than maybe a Logitech or, you know, sub-$100 webcam, this is probably going to be your best bet, even if you have to take your mobile phone offline for a little while to record your YouTube video. It's giving a pretty good capture. Again, the iPhone 12 Pro with the integrated camera using Epicam from Elgato. I would say two thumbs up for this one. This is amazing technology, all wireless and lowest cost. You do need a tripod or some way to mount it. But once you've got that sorted, it is an amazing camera.